Hey, my name is Cedric, and in this video, I will show you how to send event to the Facebook Pixel. And what we'll be doing together in this video is I'll show you how to install the Facebook Pixel on one of our landing page, and then I'll show you how you can send an event, like a lead event, to the Facebook Pixel. So anyways, let me share my screen and I'll show you how to do it. All right, so I am now in Events Manager, and you can navigate there by clicking the hamburger menu and then clicking on Events Manager. Now, you're gonna see that there's a button here that says Add Events. So once you click it, you're gonna see that there's three options. So we're gonna be clicking the second option today. And what we're gonna be doing is adding the Facebook Pixel to my WordPress website, because that's what I'm using in this example, but I'm gonna show you how you would connect it to a different platform. And then after that, we're gonna be sending those custom events. But I just wanna say that there is a lot of different methods and ways to send data to the Facebook Pixel. We're gonna be covering one method in this video that I would say is probably a little bit more beginner friendly, meaning that you don't need to know how to code and you don't need to rely on any sort of other third-party software like Google Tag Manager. So it will be really beginner friendly, but potentially also limited into what you can potentially send. So I just wanted to mention that, but with that being said, now let me show you how you would add that to your website. So I click this option and we're actually gonna be using the partner integration. And now here you go, there is a long list of different partners that Facebook integrates with. As I mentioned, I'm using WordPress, so I'm gonna be clicking on the WordPress option. Now it is telling me that I need to add a specific plugin called Facebook for WordPress. So I'm gonna go to my WordPress website and I'm under the plugin section and I'm gonna click add new. And I'm gonna type Facebook. And perfect, that's the one right here. Install now and activate. And we're gonna go to the settings. And we're gonna click the Get Started button. Now you're gonna see something like this, so a pop-up. I'm gonna hit continue. And now that's where you're gonna need to select the Business Manager, the Ad Account, and then Facebook Pixel. So I'm gonna select the Business Manager. I'm gonna just select my demo ad account. And then my demo Facebook Pixel. And let me just make sure that the code matches the one we have here. Perfect, so we're good to go. Now it's just asking if we wanted to be doing advanced matching. In this demo, we won't be doing advanced matching, and advanced matching basically means that we are sending some extra information with that event. So if you are able to send something like the person's first name, last name, email, and phone number, and you are allowed and you have permission from the user to send that information to Facebook, then I would recommend that you do enable advanced matching. It's gonna allow Facebook to, when you receive that event, to match that within the actual Facebook ad account. And then you could potentially see some more results when you're looking at your metrics in Ads Manager. But since this is a demo, I am not going to turn this on. So I'm going to leave this off and hit continue. And I'm going to hit next. And it is just linking it now. And perfect, we're all done. So now that it says that it's connected, what I always like to do is just verify and see if it's actually connected. So what I'll do is I'll go to the landing page and I'll open it. And this is actually, like I said, a real landing page that we ran, and that was actually for our Valentine's Day campaign. So we were giving out 5 of our most useful Facebook ads tool. And the way that I can see if the Facebook Pixel is actually installed properly on the website and it actually is firing for something like a page view event is by actually using this Chrome extension right here. So it is called the Facebook Pixel Helper, and we can even leave the link of this Chrome extension in the description of this video so you can go ahead and download it. But it's actually really, really helpful, and it's one way to see if your events are firing properly. So that is actually our pixel right here. So the demo pixel, that's the one that I just installed, and it's currently sending a page view event. Now, unfortunately, with this setup that we currently have, it's only gonna be able to send page view event. It's not gonna be able to send things like, let's say, a lead event to Facebook. That is actually something that we're gonna need to add. So in order to add that, I'm gonna go to Events Manager, and remember this button here, we're gonna click it again, and we're gonna click on From the Pixel. And we're gonna open up this setup tool. Just simply add my website URL. And now this little tool will pop up, and it's actually pretty cool. So it gives you 2 different options. You can either create a trigger that when the trigger is true, that's what fires the event, for example, an add to cart event or a lead event to Facebook, or you can use the page URL as a trigger. So in this example, we're going to be using the track URL as our trigger and not the track the button. And the reason for that is because when we build this landing page, we're actually using a HubSpot form. So when you use something like a HubSpot form or an ActiveCampaign form, usually these forms are actually embedded form. And Facebook and other tools like Google Tag Manager have a really hard time of knowing what is a button and what is not a button because they can't really read the information on the page. If you have something like a custom HTML form or a button that is actually made in HTML, it's not embedded, then this feature here should be able to see and detect that button. But just to show you, if I click it, you're gonna see that the button, we can't see anything here with the button. But if we look at the logo, the Facebook setup tool understands that this is clickable. And when people actually click this, it actually brings them to my actual homepage website. And if we look at the top here, Facebook knows that those are all different buttons, which it's not really useful in this example because the only reason I'm seeing this is because I'm logged into my WordPress website. But with that being said, we won't be able to use this specific setup in order to trigger our lead event. But if you are able to do it, that is a great way to send an event to Facebook. So I'm going to back out and we're going to do the track URL. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to fill up the form and I'm going to show you a little bit how I set up this landing page. I'm going to hit the submit button. So notice that it's actually bringing us to this page and it's actually not bringing us to the page showing all the different tools that they now have. And the reason for that is because when someone submits the form, they actually receive an email and it'll probably go to that page pretty often. So if we redirected users directly to that page, well, we would basically be sending lead event to Facebook every time someone goes in. So what we had to do is we had to kind of create a page that is in the middle. So when someone submits a form, it brings them to this page. And then what we did is we actually, if I move this, we actually said this, okay, well, if you want to open up your gifts, simply click the gift box. And then when they click that, that actually takes them to the page where they can access all the resources. And they'll also have that link in the email that we've just sent. But again, the reason why we set it up this way is so that we don't send a lead event every time someone wants to access their resources. So now this is what we're going to be using as our trigger, right? This page. So let me actually show you how to create that trigger. So we're going to click on track a URL. And now here we're going to need to select the event. So in my case, this is actually going to be a lead event. Let's say you were doing this for your e-commerce store, right? You could potentially track the page URL and when it maybe says thank you or order received or something like that, then that would be what you're using as your trigger and you would go ahead and pick the purchase event. But again, in this example, it is a lead event. Now, if we look here, track the entire URL or a portion of the URL. So we have the option to either say equals or contains. Let's actually just pick contains. And because I know that there's only three pages and there's not a lot of different URLs, we can actually say that if the URL contains Happy Valentine's, well, that means that someone is on this specific page and that I want to be sending a lead event to Facebook. So let's do that. Great. And if I bring this up a little bit, you're going to be able to see that we can actually add a value to the lead or to the purchase if you're doing that for an e-commerce store. And then you can also add a currency. Now, in this example, I'm not going to add anything, but if you wanted to, that's where you would. And I'm going to hit confirm. And now perfect. So we actually just created a trigger. And when someone lands on a page on this specific website and the URL contains Happy Valentine's, well, that will actually send a lead event to Facebook. So I'm going to hit finish setup and hit finish again. And let's say I'm really happy. Perfect. So now it should be all set up, but whenever you make changes like that to your tracking, to your website, or to honestly anything, you always want to make sure and see if it's working properly. So that's exactly what we're going to do. So we're going to navigate to test events. And here there's actually a little tool that we can use to see if their events are being sent properly, a little bit like the Facebook Pixel Helper. But what we're going to do is we're going to go here to the landing page. We're going to copy the URL and just paste it in and click on open website. Great. So now on this page, we're not sending really any custom event, but we do have the Facebook Pixel installed. So we should receive a page view event in that little tool. So let's actually see. Perfect. So we are receiving a page view event. Now let's actually submit the form and see if we receive a lead event. Okay. So we should see a lead event now. And perfect, we are seeing a two-page view events, right? Because we visited two different pages, and we are seeing a lead event because when someone lands on that page that contains the word or the keyword Happy Valentine's, then that's what triggers our lead event. So to recap what we did in this video, we installed the basic Facebook pixel on the website so that we can send events like page view. Unfortunately, I mean, we were not able to track button click as a way to send a lead. So like I mentioned, I had to create this special and unique page in order to bring the user there as soon as they submit the form. But then the user would be able to access the resources when they open up the gift. And that is actually the page that they would see when they submit the form.
All right, so there you have it. This is how you can set up your Facebook custom conversions without the help of any tools, just Facebook. But if you prefer to do this via Google Tag Manager, you should definitely check out this tutorial right here where I'll show you just that. And if this video helped you out in any way, then we'd love for you to hit that thumbs up button so we can share this out to more and more people. Now, on behalf of Cedric and myself, happy measuring.